Hello, this is Victoria Knox. I am the old school Brujah, and today I'm returning to the Isle of Melinat to continue my playthrough of Kingsfield. If you missed my last video, Kingsfield is the first game that was released in the United States in the Kingsfield series by From Software. It was released in 1995 on the PlayStation console. Last time, we collected some basic items, got ourselves geared up, and went through the north and south villages, the small mine, and into the first base. This time, we're going to start by going through the Underworld prison number one, base number two, the termite nest, the central village, and the first and second pirate caves. We're also going to unlock the golden fountain in the area that I believe is called Old Hand. So for now, let's start with Underworld Prison number one. The Underworld Prison number one is located just outside of the first base. We picked up the key last time from one of the soldiers in the lower level of the first base. There's only one guard in the Underworld Prison, and he happens to be an archer. Don't think that the archers are no longer dangerous just because you close the distance between you and them. They actually punch pretty hard. There's a secret door here, which I'm going to go through in a second, but there's something that I need to pick up first. I have a feeling this guy was an officer or a soldier in the king's army. You'll notice that he calls you Alexander, and this is really the first time that you learn your own identity in this story. You play the role of Alexander Thornton Reginus, who is a friend of the king. And he kindly gives us a dragon stone, and you'll see what the dragon stone is for in just a second. I'm only clearing out this cell because it's not a bad idea to pick up these earth herbs. It's a little bit of free healing. I'm not sure if the note on the wall is identifying this place as Old Hand or the warning was signed by somebody named Old Hand. Whatever the case may be, I'm calling this space Old Hand. This is the location of the Golden Fountain. You can see the stone is that light color that is over at my favorite save point where I have my star key set. Looking around the room, you'll notice that there are three channels in the floor. Each one is meant to have water running through it. Only one of them, the blue channel, is open right now. The dragon crystals open the floodgates that allow the other waters to come through to the Golden Fountain. So the three types of water are blue for health restoration, green for status restoration, and pink for magic restoration. Because magic is more important to me at this stage in the game, I'm going to open up the pink channel. I know I could just run past these archers, but I'm actually going to take them all out. Some of them have important items for me. As you can see, this one right here has a rhombus key. And I really want to start picking up some arrows. Just looking around to see if I missed any more soldiers. You'll notice there's a small door over here that is to the large mine. We're not quite ready to go into the large mine yet. We're headed towards the central village, which is in this direction. We just have a few more guards to go past to get there. With the archers, I try to keep them stunlocked, just because they're a little bit dangerous at any range at this point. Now, here we have one of those checkpoint quests. We can't progress until we find this woman's son. Her little boy, Sandler, is missing. He has gone off in search of adventure, and until he comes home safely, nobody in this town will really deal with you. They'll block doors, they'll keep you from being able to progress any further. We could go into the large mine instead and sort of bypass this area, but there isn't really a reason for us to do that. If you listen carefully, you can hear termites down here. So we're not far from the termite nest. I'm not going in it just yet. I want to stop by the base number 2 first, and you'll see why in a second. This rod that I just picked up shows secret doors. They can be useful, but you can actually, if you look carefully enough, you can find polygon breakup around some of the secret doors, which makes the rods a little bit unnecessary. Okay, this is the base number 2. And we'll just clear out these guards, and I will show you what's important about this room. This is our first ranged weapon. It's just a simple bow. There is a crossbow or an arbalest that's available later on, but this is a reasonable weapon to start with, and we need it before we head into the termite nest. I'm a little hesitant to cross this bridge here. You can't quite see it, but if you were able to look into the shadows, over there is a pair of archers who are waiting for you. And unfortunately, we can't cross the gap beside them just yet. We'll be back here. And that hole in the wall is the termite nest. Okay, now I have everything that I need to be able to successfully make my way through the termite nest, but I just want to make sure that I'm at full health before I do that. So I'm going to run back using my Stargate to my favorite little save point and just make sure that I heal myself up at the blue fountain, and then I will head into the termite nest. Because I have somewhere to be, I'm not even going to bother fighting these guards right now. I am just going to keep on running. This is the Seer Meryl. If you're not sure what an item does, you can bring it to her, show it to her, and she will tell you what it is, what it does. She tends to appear randomly in different spots around the island. So she'll be in that hidden room. She could be in the hidden room that's a little bit earlier. And she can also, I've spotted her in the central village. I'm not sure if I told you before, but running across a trapdoor will actually carry you safely across the trapdoor. Okay, this is the termite nest. Obviously, we're going to be fighting a lot of termites. We're going to be fighting some rilks, and we're also going to encounter something a little unusual. Okay. This is the golden tree. There are a few golden trees scattered around the island, and they do something really cool. So I'm just going to attack it. I know it doesn't make sense, but trust me. I don't know if you can see it, but up by the upper branches, there is a tiny light-colored translucent dot. That is the beginning of a dragon crystal. Attacking the golden trees forces them to produce these. It takes a little while for them to grow, so I am going to run around and do some other things while it ripens. You can see there is an upper layer and a lower layer to the termite nest, and it all surrounds this central chamber. There are a fair number of crystals to be collected down here, so pick them up. You're going to be able to use them as soon as we find poor Sandler. I want to call him Sandal. I almost hear him saying, "Enchantment!" I know he doesn't, but something about the name. While you're fighting the termites, remember that aside from having a very strong bite, they do have the ability to paralyze. So try not to let yourself get surrounded. If you do, be fast on the start button so that you can bring up your inventory menu and use a blood crystal to recover from the paralysis. Okay, this is the corridor above base number 2. There are two ways that you can exit the termite nest. One of them is to just drop out of this hole in the wall, or you can use your stargate and warp back to your key. A little bit of useful graffiti here on the wall. This is why we collected the bow. Thank you. And here we will face the mother of all termites. You can see by watching her little offspring down there that we have a handy threshold. This is fantastic. This is one of those exploits that I love so much. We can equip our bow and attack her and the offspring with total impunity. And you'll know that you hit her because, like most monsters in this game, she does have a stagger animation. Stagger, recoil, whatever you want to call it. And look at that. Three shots with a sword becomes one shot with a bow, even for these guys. There's a lot of that in Kingsfield. There is a weapon that is more effective against different types of monsters. So obviously we now know that projectile weapons are best against termites. Later on, we will see that blunt force is most effective against skeletons. There's a lot to be said for finding the best tool for the job. Sandler has given us a handy item here. This is our first treasure key. It is specifically the pirate key. And before we leave, I'm just going to clean up a few more things in here, just collect a few more items, and head back to that golden tree to pick up the dragon crystal. It should be ready by now. If it weren't for all of the termites, I would go after the rilks, but honestly the termites are dangerous enough where I think it's a safer strategy for me to just avoid them. Okay, it's getting a little dangerous here, so I'm going to put some space between myself and the termites, and I am going to bring out the heavy guns, or the heavy bow. It's easy to get turned around in here. And know that there are trapdoors in the termite nest as well. And here's my dragon crystal, which is great because, as you can see, I have one magic point left. So I'm going to use the dragon crystal. And now I'm going to use my stargate and head back to my save point. Now, since I've already taken you to the central village from this area twice so far this video, I'm gonna start cutting down. So I'm going to just quick cut back to the central village. We'll do a few little errands there, and then we will head over to the pirate cave. I should note, I had completely forgotten about Rad Bilheim. I remembered there was a guy with the goggles. I forgot that he was also a crystal smith. Leon is not the only crystal smith on this island, but Leon is a far more significant crystal smith. So Rad is the guy who will build your flasks. Leon is the one who will build figures of Seath for you. He will also make a unique weapon for you. In the second game, Leon Shore is actually the crystal smith who creates the Exelector, which is your starting weapon. And it is a crystal sword with this really interesting property where it levels with you. It's not a continuous progression kind of thing, but it goes in tiers. So when you begin the game, it is a dagger. After you've reached a certain level, it transforms into a short sword, and then later on it transforms yet again into a longsword. And here is another door to the old hand area. So you can see how the hub is starting to form around that golden fountain in the center. So in my last video, I mentioned that my favorite place to save is right outside of the North Village, near Nola Bagil's place. And the reason why I like that spot is early on, it is close to a healing fountain. Later on, when Old Hand is opened, it is next to this central hub of the island, and you can get to several different fairly distant locations very quickly just by crossing through this room. If you look across the lava river, you will notice there are some wandering skeletons. We will eventually go there, not quite yet, but it's worth noting, this is Harvine's castle. In the first video, we passed by a pair of snails and picked up the wind crystal in an area where there was a plaque on the wall which read, "This is where King Harvine began to build his castle." Well, clearly you can see there is a Harvine's castle on this island. Okay, now that we're done with the central village and picked up a few more things that happen to open up, we are going to head to the Pirate's Cave. And to do that, we go back to the beginning.
Thank you.
I know this shield would have been handy to have at the beginning, but honestly, I just hate fighting skeletons enough where I'm comfortable leaving it until a little bit later. And of course, because it's been programmed into me, I'm just going to save really quickly. Well, maybe not so quickly, since it's a little bit of a run to get there. Okay, so we're going to go back to the original landing on the beach, and we are going to head along the coast to the south. Now, I'd like to get to that little stretch of beach that you can see ahead. Unfortunately, there is no land bridge between where I'm standing and there. So instead, we have to go through this cave, and there is a walkway upstairs that we will use. Whenever you encounter one of these long, narrow hallways, chances are there's a trapdoor, so it's safest to just run. We know we're in pirate territory because we just picked up a pirate's map. Yeah. Now, I forgot to use this earth crystal after picking up Sandler. This teaches us the stone spell. And I'm just going to show you how effective stone is against skeletons. You're going to love this. It's a great spell for dealing with them. It's a little bit expensive and it takes a little bit of time to charge up, but it is worth it. Now this is one of the things that I don't necessarily like about this game. Sometimes you think that you've made a clear shot, but your spell will get stuck on a wall. For something as expensive as stone, it's worth taking a little bit of extra time and making sure that you line it up and that you have a completely unobstructed view. Trust me, just walk into the blades. I'm not trying to run past these blades. I'm just trying to make it to the trapdoor without getting hit. These things that look like dandelions are actually antidote herbs. Lucky for us, the skeletons never expect a stone to the face. For that matter, neither do snails. Moonstones are in the dragon crystal family. They restore a small amount of magic. I believe that room is above the chamber with the snails, where we came up the stairs and crossed the walkway. That would be the land route out of the pirate cave. Unfortunately, we're not quite done here yet. We are looking for one or two more items before we go. Three skeletons in one room. Whatever's in here must be important. I'm going to handle them the slow but easy way. I'm equipping the Morning Star because it is more effective against the skeletons than the Night Sword. It's not as effective as the Stone Spell, but it is also significantly faster. Now this is the most important thing down here. This is the skull key. Thank you. There are three chests here. One of them is safe and contains a piece of verdite. The second one contains a surprise skeleton. So that's the most important stuff in the pirate cave, or at least this pirate cave. Now we're going to go to the second part of the pirate cave system. And for this, we're going to teleport back to our favorite save point and head in the opposite direction. We're going to go north, back to the cave behind the waterfall where we found the knight's sword. Just because I'm using a lot more magic now, I'm actually going to take a chance and steal the dragon crystal from in front of the giant kraken. At this point in the game, it's worth it for me to get hit. And like the rhombus key, the skull key fits nicely into this skull key-shaped recess. This is the first water crystal that we've encountered in the game. It'll teach us our first water-based spell. And here we've picked up the third of the dragon crystals. Now that we have this, let's head back to Underworld Prison Number 1. We're going to head back through the unlocked cell and make our way toward Old Hand. The third dragon stone will unlock the green channel, and the fountain will then become active, producing gold water. The gold water restores health, magic, and status. Obviously, this is the best stuff that I can have in my crystal flasks, so what I'm going to do is use all of my blue potions so that I have my empty flasks back. And now I'll fill them all up. And those are our gold potions. Now that the golden fountain is running again, the doors that were locked into this area from the north village entrance and the central village entrance are now open. So we have our nice central hub from which we can get to different ends of the island. So that was the second part of our Kingsfield video series. We went through the central village, the second base, the termite nest, Old Hand, and the two pirate caves. This has been Victoria Knox, the Old School Brujah, and I hope to see you next time. Thanks for playing.